Today we have to start with the grassland ecosystem. Okay, so grassland is an area where the vegetation is dominated by grasses. So it is fully covered with grasses, with the plants, trees. Okay, so then it is also called as transitional landscape. Why it is called as transitional landscape? Because grassland ecosystems are dominated by the grass with a few or no trees in that area. Okay, it is dominated with the few or no trees in that area, so it is fully covered with grass only. So only few or little trees are found in that region. So since there is less amount of rainfall, the forest ecosystem has changed into a grassland ecosystem. If there is heavy rainfall, what will happen? It will lead to the growth of more number of plants and trees. So all types of plants and trees. Since there is limited rainfall, what is happening? It leads to the change in the forest ecosystem, and it is totally converted into a grassland ecosystem where you can see only the vegetation is dominated by grasses and other non-woody plants. But in case of trees, only few trees or no trees are found in that area. It is mostly depending on the rainfall only. Since it gets limited amount of rainfall, the forest system has been entirely changed into a grassland ecosystem. So next I'll tell you about the characteristics of the grassland ecosystem. That is, the vegetation structure has been dominated by grasses. So only grasses are found there. So here and there, only few or limited amount of trees are seen. Then it receives very little rainfall, so that is why this region is having semi arid climate. So what do you mean by arid? That is, it receives less or no rainfall. Okay, so then third characteristic is the rainfall and soils is insufficient to support the significant tree growth. So if there is heavy rainfall, what will happen? The soil will be fertile and it will be filled with nutrients such that it will be suitable for growing more number of trees and plants. But because of the insufficient or adequate rainfall, what is happening? There is insufficient growth in the plants and trees. And next is the most common at mid latitudes and near the interiors of continents, and where this grassland ecosystem is situated at the mid latitudes, the region near the mid latitudes and near the interiors of the continents. And next is, grasslands are often exploited for agricultural use. And these, as I told you before itself, the grasslands have been cleared, even the forest, thick forests have been cleared in order to build more number of buildings, constructions of buildings, then building industries, factories, like that. But now these grasslands have been often cleared for growing crops, that is for agricultural use. And there are two types of grasslands. They are the tropical grasslands and temperate grasslands. So the classification of these grasslands are based on which latitude this forest is located and the temperature this region has. So based upon the classification of the grasslands, that is, what are the two types of grasslands? Tropical grasslands and temperate grasslands. So this classification is based on the latitude in which this forest is located and the temperature in which this region is lying. Okay, so next we are going to see about the topic, the area. So where this region is lying. So this tropical grasslands are also called as the savanna. Okay, that is S-A-V-A-N-N-A. So these tropical grasslands are also called as savanna. So where these tropical grasslands are found? Now I'll show you. On either side of the tropical rainforest. Here you can see in this map. So where these tropical grasslands are found? On either side of the tropical rainforest, that is between the two tropics, What is the two tropics? That is the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, which is on either side of the equator. So wait, I'll show you in another map, children. That's it. It will be clear for you. Here you can see. So where the desert saying on either side of the tropics, that is here you can see the equator. Here you can see Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So the two types of grasslands are classified based upon which the latitude it is located, this forest is located, and the temperature this region is having. Okay. So where these tropical grasslands are found? On either side of the tropical rainforest, that is between the two tropics. What are the two tropics? That is the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, which is on either side of the equator. So based on the location of the latitudes, these grasslands are located. So these tropical grasslands cover a large part of Africa. Here you can see. The tropical grasslands cover a large part of Africa, which is called as savanna. Okay, so the spelling of savanna is S-A-V-A-N-N-A. And next, in South America, these grasslands are called as llanos. Okay, llanos, campos, in parts of the Deccan Plateau in India and Northern Australia. Okay, and next is, we are going to see about climate. So what climate these tropical grasslands are experiencing? So it experiences hot rainy season and a warm dry season. So what about the climate? It experiences hot rainy season and warm dry season. Then in a year of 6 to 8 months, this region gets rainfall about 50 centimeter 200 centimeter. So for just think about this region. How many months does this region get rainfall? That is from 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter. For in a year, it is receiving 6 to 8 months of rainfall. Okay. So, because of less rain and most moist conditions, what is happening? In this region, it is not well suited for the growth of the plants in this forest. That is, it is receiving less amount of rainfall, only 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter. It is very, very less. Okay. But when you compare to the evergreen forest and the deciduous forest, you know, more than 250 centimeter, this is very high rainfall. If it is between 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter, it receives little rainfall. That is between 6 to 8 months in a year. So because of less rainfall, this region is not well suited for the growth of the plants in this forest. Okay. And next we are going to see about the vegetation. What are the plants which are grown in this region? So elephant grass are grown here. Okay. Elephant grass are grown here. So these elephant grass are tall in nature. They are very, very tall in nature, which are sometimes more than 2 meters in height. Okay. So these, what are the plants grown here? Elephant grass. And elephant grass are very, very tall in nature, such that it sometimes it will grow more than 2 meters in height. Then, next plant is, it is a kind of tree, that is baobab. It is a kind of tree found scattered in this region. So, here and there you can see this plant grown. So, baobab is a kind of tree found scattered in this region. And next we are going to see about the wildlife, the animals that is found in this region. So animals like giraffe, zebras, then deer, buffaloes, elephants, lion, cheetah, leopard, hyenas, and large flightless birds like ostrich and rhea are found in this region. So these are the animals which are found in the tropical grasslands. And next, we are going to proceed with the next topic, temperate grasslands. So, where do these zones lie? So now we are going to see about the area where this region, that is the temperate grasslands, lie, are located. So in this zone lie in the temperate zone between 25 degree and 55 degree latitudes in both the northern and the southern hemisphere. So these grasslands are seen in the interiors. So the temperate grasslands are seen in the interiors of the continent. Okay. Then under that we have the prairies in North America, then pampas in South America, steppes in Eurasia, high veld in South Africa, and downs in Australia. So next we are going to see about the climate. So this region experiences warm summers and cold winters. This region experiences warm summers and cold winters. So this region gets very less rainfall, about 25 to 75 centimeter. So what about the tropical grasslands? It receives about 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter. In case of temperate grasslands, they receive very less rainfall, that is about 25 to 75 centimeter, which is inadequate for the growth of the trees because it won't get sufficient water for the plants to grow. So it receives very, very less rainfall, which ranges about 25 centimeter to 75 centimeter. And next we are going to see about what are the plants which are growing there in this temperate grasslands, that is the vegetation. Since there is less rainfall, these grasslands have very few trees like willow, then alder and poplar. So only soft grass are grown here. So these grasslands are used for cattle rearing and sheep rearing. Okay. So here farming is done such that crops like wheat and corn are grown here. And they are considered to be the main crops which are grown in this temperate grasslands. So you can see in this picture. So these grasslands are being used for cattle rearing and sheep rearing, such that these grasslands have been totally cleared for growing crops in order to do farming. And crops like wheat and corn are grown in this region, which are the main crops of the temperate grasslands. And very few trees are found in this region, like willow, then alder and poplar. So only soft grass are grown there, so which is used for the animals. And next we are going to see about the wildlife. So animals like antelopes, then giraffe, horses, leopards, wolves, rabbits, wild asses are found in this region. And next, marsupials. So what do you mean by marsupials? They are the mammals. Okay, so they are the mammals like kangaroo, then flightless birds like emu are also found in Australia. So these are the animals which are found in the temperate grasslands. And next we are going to see about desert ecosystem. So this topic will be familiar for you. So you would have learned about this topic, desert ecosystem, when you learn the physical divisions of India, you would have learned about Thar desert. So based upon that, we can get some information about that. So what do you mean by the term aridity? So aridity means very dry and without enough rainfall, such that if there is enough rainfall, the plants will grow well. If there is no rainfall, what will happen? If there is enough, without enough rainfall, the plants won't grow properly. So water, that is the rain, it is very, very important for the growth of the plants. Okay. So we know that deserts receive very, very less rainfall. That is, it receives scanty rainfall. What do you mean by the word scanty? That means very less, very less rainfall this desert ecosystem is receiving, is getting. So let us see about the classification of deserts. So based upon the temperature conditions, deserts are categorized into three types. What are they? They are the tropical deserts, temperate deserts, and the polar deserts. Can you all see in this picture? So, based upon the temperature condition, deserts are classified into three types. They are the tropical deserts, temperate deserts, and polar deserts. So, now first we'll see about the tropical deserts. First, we'll see where these tropical deserts are lying, that is the area where it is located. So, first one is the area. So, now we are going to see where does these deserts are located. So, these tropical deserts are located between the two tropics. So, before itself I told you, what is the two tropics? What are the two tropics? That is the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn along the western margins of the continents. Can you all see in this picture here? So, where these tropical deserts are located? Between the two tropics. Here you can see Tropic of Capricorn.
Here
you can see Tropic of Cancer. So, Sahara Desert, then Kalahari Desert and Namib Desert in Africa. Then Sonoran Desert in North America. Here, the Atacama Desert in South America. Thar Desert in Asia over here. That is in India, in the state of Rajasthan. And the Great Australian Desert here. So, all these deserts are considered to be some of the most important deserts in the world. And next, we are going to see about the climate. So, we know that deserts have extreme temperatures. That is, during the daytime, it will be very, very hot. And during the nighttime, it will be cold. So, last week itself I told you that about the offshore winds. So, first I'll tell you what is onshore wind and then I'll proceed with offshore wind. Onshore wind is the one that blows from the sea towards the land. On the other hand, offshore winds are, it is a type of wind that blows from the land towards the sea. So, these winds usually occur due to the differences in pressure in the atmosphere. Okay. Then, offshore winds blow in these regions, which leads to very, very little rainfall. So, that is less than 25 centimeter. When you compare it with evergreen forest or deciduous forest, they will receive more than, evergreen forest will receive 200, more than 200 and 200 centimeter of rainfall. Whereas deciduous forest, 150 centimeter, more than 150. Then, here, for a tropical grasslands, it receives 50 to 100 centimeter. For temperate grasslands, it receives about 25 to 75. For desert ecosystem, you can see that it receives only less than 25 centimeter. That means very, very little rainfall. So, do you think the vegetation, the plants will be grown in large amount? No. So, you can see plants and trees in this desert ecosystem. Okay. So, because of the offshore winds which blow in this region, it is leading to very, very little rainfall in this region, that is less than 25 centimeter. So, now we'll see about the vegetation. So, since this region receives very little rainfall, what will happen? There's no plants and trees, as we can see in the plains and the other regions. For example, in plains, you know, the northern plains. That region is fed with water. So, it has more number of rivers, which is always fed with water, and it arises, and these rivers arise from the snow-capped region, that is the northern mountains. Yes or no? And that region is very, very fertile. And it gets maximum rainfall. But in case here, in the desert system, this region receives very little rainfall or no rainfall, such that it affects the growth of the plants and trees. Okay. But when you compare it with the plains, just the opposite in the desert ecosystem. Then you can see only plants like xerophytes are grown here. So, what do you mean by xerophytes? That is, the plants which need very less water for growing. So, that plants are called as xerophytes. Okay, and next, transpiration is very, very less in these desert regions. First, let me tell about what is transpiration. So you'd have heard about this word, that is transpiration in science. So transpiration means the evaporation of water from the plants. So most of the water is absorbed by the root of plant, as much as 99.9%, which is not used for the growth. So we might think, whatever amount of water that the roots are absorbing from the soil, we think that the whole plant is making use of the water for growth. No, it is not like that. The excess water, okay, the plants leaves through the transpiration. Okay, so it is the excess water is lost only through the transpiration. So the plants in the deserts have waxy stems, thorny or small leathery leaves, long roots and thick barks, which prevents the loss of water through transpiration. So transpiration is very, very less in these desert regions. Okay, so this is what transpiration. So plants like date palm, then cactus, thorny bushes and acacia are found in this region. Next we are going to see about the wildlife. So not only the living beings, even the animals and plants also have to adapt to the environment. So animals like camel, antelopes, gazelles, wild asses, hare, rodents, desert foxes, then lizards, snakes, hyenas are also found in this region. And camel is considered to be the most important animal in the desert. Why? Because camel can survive in the desert without drinking water for many days. Above all, camel is used for the transportation from one place to another in the desert. So camel is called as the ship of the desert. Our next topic is temperate deserts. I think so, time is